Hello there! In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make a quote to appear less boring. No matter if you use PowerPoint for presentations, you use Photoshop for ebooks or some other designs, you most likely sometimes use quotes and you would like that they appear nicer. So once in a while, and not only in PowerPoint, but in design, in posters, in photographs, you want to use quotations. You want to quote someone, you want to make the quote look good, but this doesn't always work because a quote is text and text doesn't look good. And I want to show you a clean, simple slide how it can be done to make it look good. Now, quotes are often put into quotation marks. So at first, let me copy the text so I have another text box and put quotation marks here. I'll even put them separately. So I'll once again copy that, select the first one and delete the second one. Okay. I have the quotes and I will make this smaller, or not as small, because I want the quotation marks to be really, really outstandingly big. Okay. They should be huge. Okay. So you will really see, yep, that is a quote. Okay. Now PowerPoint doesn't help me at all here because the font tries to be as big as the letters are. Okay. So I have the first quote. Let me maybe delete this and I'll put them here. Then I'll duplicate them. I'll maybe, or let them stay like that. I'll place them on the right side. And in between them, we want the quote to fit. Now we need to select another font. Now Mark Twain, an artist, and don't mind the quote. This is just a very example quote I took from over the internet. And I'll just select another font, something more elegant. And I would like it to fit the author. So something nice like that, Bellotta. Yep, this Bellotta bold looks really amazing. And I think we'll use that. I'll Control C, Control V, so I'll only have the Mark Twain left. Okay, we need to adjust that. Let me put Mark Twain here. Now this text can be, of course, bigger because we don't have much text here. We can make the quote like that. And I'll also justify it like this, so it will be more of a rectangle than a design like that. Okay, and we can start to place everything. Okay, and we can start to put everything in place. Okay, I'll take this one and I'll just make it like that, so it looks a bit more interesting. Now, I want some connection between them, so I'll go to Insert, Shapes, and let me make a super, super simple design like that. Okay, let's take a half frame. I'll take my Shift key and I'll select a color. Shape outline, no outline, shape fill, more fill colors, and let me select a pleasant green color, a friendly one. Oh, this is toxic, not friendly. Okay, let's select a friendly green color. I'll make this much smaller. Okay, this color isn't friendly at all. More fill colors, and I'll go deeper. I want it to be washed out. Yeah, now it's more friendly. Okay, I'll make it smaller. I'll shift it around and okay. Let me make it like that. This here smaller. Okay, and now those two dots are connected, like this one is connected with the upper one. Now, immediately you see that the text is in the middle. Now I think the text is too big. Oh, the Mark Twain should be deleted here. And you can put this in the middle. Now I can also make this gray, the text, because the text here is too strong. You see, the design starts to become a bit more friendly. It looks a bit better. Mark Twain, don't you want to be here? And I can even Control C, Control V. Let's maybe write here writer and satirist. Okay. And this one can have the same friendly green color. So I'll go to Format, Text Fill, and I'll select my recent color. I'll make it smaller, of course, because the title person should be bigger. Boom, boom, like that. Okay. And basically this would be it. I would just like to make here minor tweaks because I think those are a tiny bit too big. Such a design is really pleasant for the eye and can be used in various designs. Thank you very much for listening to this tutorial. If you want, I have more of them. You can check them out. For now, thanks for listening and see you in the next one.